When I was about going to talk here, one of my friends told me that, you know, you Kashmiris always speak against India. No doubt how much progress we are, how much liberal we are. Sometimes we have this inherent love towards our country, which can't be negated. So, sorry if I hurt anyone while talking about the oppression and the discrimination that a student of Kashmiri faces in the Indian universities. And without giving any a brief thing, the whole conflict in Kashmir because of India, Pakistan, why India wants it to establish its secular imagination to the world, and Pakistan identifies it as a religious, identifies Kashmir as a religious entity. So, leaving aside the spheres of social, economic, and political affairs, the presence going to deliver here will focus on the experience of Kashmiri students in the Indian educational institutions in mainland India. I will try to highlight the subtle forms of discrimination that predominant stereotyping of Kashmiris as the other usually come across. The other here typifies as one who not only opposed the institutionalization of repression in his her homeland, that is our Kashmir, but because of his identity of being a Muslim, by default, stands in opposition to the identity of the controlling power, that's India. Being Muslim and opposing the violence of Indian state is like treading on a double-edged sword. Our opposition to the instruments of violence like AFAS translates into anti-national since our Muslim identity is used to create a false binary of Hindu versus Muslim or India versus Pakistan. The semantics of Kashmiri as an anti-national is so pervasive that any issue that we take stand on, whether of Dalits here, Adivasis or farmer societies, necessarily translates us into the orbit of anti-national in the mainstream narrative of Indian nationalism. One way of the typical way of characterizing Kashmiris as anti-national or being of other country like Pakistan is our support for Pakistan cricket team or whether support of any other cricket team that plays against India. And there have been a lot of discussion on this issue, a lot of debates on social networking sites, thousands of articles came on different newspapers, series of debates, discussions on it. And this has spread its tentacles in the most of the institutes in which the students of Jammu and Kashmir are studying, and thus have become more vulnerable in the backdrop of rising violence and the demand for sedition charges against us or them. And I'm going to tell about the series of events of the instances that happen across the Indian institutions with the Kashmiri students, particularly while supporting any particular team which plays against India. Here I am giving the example of Swami Vivekananda University, which suspended 67 Kashmiri students when India lost its match with not Pakistan but some other country. To one's dismay, that G.S. Bansal, warden of hostel, called the punishment an outcome of anti-national act, which Kashmiris did. Finally, 10 of the suspended students were expelled from the university, which put their career on jeopardy. This incident set a chain of events which Kashmiri students were attacked in various institutes. Following this, at least 12 Kashmiri students were injured in Sami Permanent College, Mohali, Punjab, as they were attacked by local students for watching Pakistan-Sri Lanka match. The precursor to this attack was set by Warden Sandeep Singh, who objected to the students watching Pakistan-Sri Lanka match. When students insisted to watch the match, he called other local students who came up with knives, iron rods, and attacked the students. Next morning, the local population who assembled at the gate to attack the Kashmiri students. As a result, when situation was going out of college administration announced the whole day of 15 days. In other incident, 3 Kashmiri students at Noida International University were beaten up. 5 to 6 boys knocked at their door of the room. When no answer came, they barged into the room and identified the Kashmiri students, after which they were thrashed. As one of the students said, and I personally talked to him, he told me that he's one from my locality only. And he told that when I told them that there were 3 of us who are Kashmiri, they start abusing us and thrashed us. And this has happened before. It's not the first time that Kashmiri students have been bullied or being beaten up in the mostly northern India. The Kashmiri students were asked to shout India Zindabad and then were asked to repeat Pakistan Murdabad. In a very recent attack, Kashmiri students even were held accountable for the Pathankot incidents, and there was a series of assaults on Kashmiri students in whole North India. In one Sami Dayal college in Haryana, a group of local goons who were drunk, they went and barged the room, rented rooms of Kashmiri students and beat them mercilessly. And one of the students had to undergo for CT scan for multiple injuries. In this abject situation, Kashmiri students fear for life, leave alone studies, and they did exactly the same, left the exam midway and went to home. The return for them signifies constant fear, violence, and life-taking activity. Such was the fear among these students that they spent whole night at railway platform and ran home early in the morning. And here I'm just going to mention another very recent incident that happened. On 8th March last month, one Kashmiri student was released by Tihar jail after he spent 4 years there. And what was his crime was nothing. He was not involved in any activity, neither he was involved in throwing any stone on. He was just a student who was studying in a Jharkhand College of American Language, and some people came to him and asked him that they want him for some inquiry. They take him, and finally he found himself one day in Delhi, and he was interrogated, and for that he spent 3-4 years in jail, and finally he was released, and he was acquitted for being not involved in any activity, anti-national activities, but he lost his 4 years of life. And there are such incidents in which the students, the engineering student in Delhi who was arrested for Lajpat Nagar blast, he was put in jail for 18 years, and finally after 18 years he was released, and without any, was went against him. Just he spent his 18 years, in between 18 years of his life he lost his mother, sister, brother. And same incident happened with an engineer, Bashir Ahmad in Rajasthan, engineering college, where he spent more than 12 years in jail without being given a fair trial. The only crime of him was being a student, a Kashmiri student, and then being a Muslim there. And I just want to bring out the latest JNU issue also in this, how these Kashmiri students got persecuted when many of the Kashmiri students after JNU incident left the university. And when I went in Delhi Chalo in call, which was given by us here, and I didn't found any Kashmiri student there except one, and I told him where are the rest of the Kashmiri students. They told him that they fled, because in this whole national anti-national debate, the finger at the end was put on them that they were the people who raised the anti-national slogans, and they fled home because there was a constant vigilance of Delhi police on them. And when I went to Jamia Millia, I didn't meet. The strength of Jamia Kashmiri students in Jamia Millia is more than 300, but I didn't met 10. And when I told them about the certain people which I know, my friends there in Jamia Millia, I told them, where are they? They told me they left home in the very next day, and most of them who are having long beard, they trimmed it, they plain shaved it, and some of them wear the malas, try to look like a North Indian, and went back to home. And this is the height of this the things that this operation that as Kashmiri students goes. And there are, and it becomes the greatest problem for our family when we told them that there's one study outside, that the most important person which we take a long time to convince is our mother. So she does not want us to go outside study, looking at the series of incidents. In fact, we are being in the latest incident yesterday. 3 students were killed in Hanwara. In my locality, one girl who was not protesting anywhere, who was not throwing any stone anywhere, she got hit by a blood, but she was standing in the veranda of her home. And that is the height of intolerance and discrimination we see. And most of them, how could we relate with Ekalavya, is that, yeah, Ekalavya has sacrificed his thumb, but we are every time we are not here to free to express our dissent, we every time sacrifice our tongue. We have to force to remain dumb, to remain silent on the issue, on the oppression that we are going with. And it happens with the Northeastern students as well, whether it is in terms of racial profiling, it happens with us when it comes to religious profiling or regional profiling on us. And looking back into the universities I studied in, Pondicherry University, then I came here, I was never being that. There's a two sort of discrimination we find. One is that visible discrimination that teachers identify you, faculty identify you as a Kashmiri, and then discriminate with you. The second is that they talk with you nicely, they help you, they talk nicely to you in every way. But there's an discrimination that comes up. For example, we are not allowed to talk about Kashmiri in our universities. We were not giving the most of the time in Indian universities, Kashmiri students were not allowed to choose the topics they want to do research on. So always we are asking that don't take this controversial topics for your research. Don't take the women issues, Kulan Pushpa Raf incident. Don't take this other issues. Take a very normal issue of Indo-Pakistan relations, China-India relations, and all these things happen. And we are always asked not take this controversial. That's another sort of discrimination that we are facing. And there should be a discussion and deliberation on such particular events and incidents. Here I will express, I will want to share one of the experience that once in 2013, the US congressman delegation came here to university. There were the young politicians who came to our university, and student union was invited by administration to talk with them in a guest house. That time, Shisha was the president, Sandeep was general secretary, and I was a school board member and happened to go with them. And Manikanta, who was that time vice president, talked about the caste problems in Kashmir, the Brahminical dominance in this country, how these Dalits face discrimination, endless discrimination in this country. He talked about so much about India. He opened the whole India in front of them. And when I got the chance to talk about Kashmir, I talk about the human rights violations, I talk about raps, I talk about molestation, I talk about custodial deaths, disappearances. And next day we were going to book a room. That PR told some of my friends that we take a serious note of why that Kashmiri boy has speak like this in this university. And for that, even I was threatened to be summoned by the Rajasthan for it. And that happens in the Indian Pondicherry University when Afzal Guru was executed, when people were protesting against it. Administration told them, if they want to stay in hostels, don't shout like this. But as a Kashmiri student, I have experienced this north-south division in the whole administration. In North India, we mostly face such problems. We are very easily identified. We are easily bullied. We have been persecuted physically, mentally, morally. In South India, there has not been such things. But yeah, there are some invisible discrimination that I was talking about, where curtailing our research, where asking our not to take controversial steps. And that's the experience that I want to share with you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.